day, where we're standing here today. Many unfound bodies lay, of people who fought for our today. Was it an ambush or was it a raid? Whatever it was, they needed aid. There wasn't time in the price to pay. Where history was made. May all these soldiers rest in peace as the people of the world start to increase. They fought for what is now our every day, and what else is there for us today except the same people.
Abide with me.
Paper and took the silver tree and said, "Goodbye, we'll meet again if our God is willing." Some tried to stop the king from being patron of the games, but Cumberland Doyle said no to call the same. He said, "We were fit young men, so good in the tackle, that we should serve and march in the field of battle. Then we had to train, you know, before we were to go. Up and down we charged and ran in the blooming snow." They let us out on Saturday to play our secret game. Then we went right back to camp for the train again. Not only we went there, but officials and fans also. The football battalion was formed. To the war we'd go. We had a second Louis. His name was Walter Tulse. The first black infantry officer. Our life was never dull. He really was a clever guy to have as our own boss. So good was he that late was he to have a military cross. We all fought hard, but once amongst the mines, we got together and played football right between the lines. It kept us warm and spirits high, and the enemy were fun. Before we had to fight again with bayonet and gun. We fought at Delville Wood and further on the front, and on through into the battle of the famous Gillenoy. In Arras then, we fought yet another battle, losing 1,000 men to the machine gun rattle. When the war was over, we went home again. It was a small bunch of men that went off in the rain. We were still men of Clapton as we marched with heads held high. We were so proud and joyous, but they never saw us cry.
A piece of music called The Greater Game.
Alex will come with me now. I'd also like to ask Peter Kitchen to come forward, please. Round of applause to Peter, who's joined us for The Greater Game. Peter and I, along with a colleague of ours, Michael Head, have been working very hard over the past few years regarding the faith of that thing called The Greater Game. And it was successfully staged in 2016 to coincide with the centenary of the Battle of the Somme. And I'll ask Peter to give you an update on the situation briefly. Over to you, Peter. Thank you.
Well, before I do, Steve, I just want to congratulate you on a fantastic weekend. I'm sure everybody is having a great The outcome of the war might have been different. As Steve said, we worked with the co-producers on the play The Greater Game. And we're very pleased to announce that subject to contract, because we're waiting to see the contract before we can sign it, that we've managed to get sponsorship from the Football League, the FA, the Premier League and the PFA. So we've got the four football authorities behind us and backing the play, and also the Remembrance Supporters Club as well, and we will be having this production at the Waterloo Theatre on the 28th of October for a month, and there will also be a special show on Remembrance Sunday. So that's a fantastic thing to happen, to tell this great story that we're all here celebrating and commemorating about your...
This is a song that was written by Andy Goldstone and myself, which we played here 2 years ago. The gentleman singing generally with the guitar, coupled with the conversion of Alex with his amazing box here. We all sing along to this time with the music, the words that we've got here. Please, over to you, Alex. Thank you.
This is
my story.
Mr. McFadden, sadly reported the death of my friend and old colleague William Jonas on the morning of Thursday the 27th of July, page 26. Both Willie and I were trapped in a trench near to the front in Somme, France. Willie turned to me and said, "Goodbye, Matt. Best of luck. Special love to my sweetheart, Mary Jane. And best regards to the lad at home." Before I could reply to him, he was up and over. No sooner had he jumped up out of the trench, my best friend of nearly 20 years was killed before my eyes.
she read how women died. A love is round her neck, she always wore. So that close to him she'd be, until eternity.
Precious in your sight, unique individuals, loved and blessed in so many ways. We stand in awe of the one who has created all things and dedicate this time and all our days to your service. Accept this offering, we pray, our sacrifice of praise and worship. Amen.
Judas, fall out.
Thank you.